This is part of an ongoing series on creating a website with Python, Django, and Wagtail CMS. This is not necessarily a tutorial series. This is a project that we're trying to have done in the next couple of months to port a website from Drupal over to Django and Wagtail. So let me get this project running. I just had to close a couple Docker image to get my port back. And let's get our browser up. Oops, there it is. So the website is an online magazine publication and community website for Western Friend, and it's an organization in the Western United States. It's a nonprofit organization, and I'm realizing that I'm kind of approaching this in a way that's maybe not sort of conventional for Django. It's more influenced by the Drupal, the way things work in Drupal. In Drupal, a lot of things are done through the user interface. So, you know, we'll define taxonomies and things like that all through the UI. And then you can dynamically code those using what are called views, which are essentially queries. That you program through the user interface as well. Django and Wagtail don't really have those type of the type of a workflow. Everything is primarily done in the code in terms of the site structure and categorization. And then you create content that fills in that structure. So what I'm thinking is that where I left off last time was trying to develop this community page. And I had a lot of uncertainty here, and I ended up implementing like these proxy models, like a yearly meeting page that has a reference to a contact, and then this community yearly meeting. This might still be useful, but what I'm seeing here is that I'm introducing a lot of complexity, and so I want to just simplify things. And the complexity was introduced so that I could be flexible, so to give the editor the possibility to define the content. You know, if there are new contact types, that content manager can just add them here. But what that's translating to is really complexity in the code, and I just don't know how to sort of resolve that. I've tossed it around in my mind, thought through several avenues or approaches, but I think just the way to go about it is going to be a pretty conventional thing to move these contact types into the model definition for the contact as an enum of choices. This is just the way you do certain types of categorizations. Let's see, Wagtail. Wagtail has this feature called snippets, which are, I started off using for departments, and they're sort of a way that you can define custom content that can be included in templates and also referenced from other models. But when it comes to like filtering and displaying these snippets, the code can't really rely on any preconceived notion of like what the categories are, in this case, what types of contacts we have. And I just plain need to construct the templates with some preconceived notions, basically. So I'm going to move these into the code. I'm going to remove this model. This will remain because the community page is going to have this mini, let's see, one to many relationship with yearly meetings, and they're orderable, so we need this. But the yearly meeting, instead of a yearly meeting page, will be a contact. All right, so this is the essence of the changes I'm going to try today. It's really a shame because this was looking really good. I was kind of excited that we could define contact types through the UI. But if we go to this community directory and I view like a meeting here. Yeah, like the point-and-click UI stuff goes quite a long ways, but then it starts to get really complex and buggy and difficult to debug, and so I think that's a good reason for this stuff to live in code. This is a good reminder right here. This is supposed to be showing some sub... let me think here. Boulder Friends meeting. Probably doesn't have any worship groups now that I think about that, but there's this empty field here. All right, so... But if you look here, we get quarterly and regional meetings and monthly meetings. So I might have to change the way this works. But the main point here is that these contacts, like this in Mountain Yearly Meeting is rendering this kind of custom layout. These are called pages or panels, basically. In you define the structure through the user interface, and you define these kind of queries that are basically SQL underneath the thing, but you do it through point and click, through views. I don't have these kind of capabilities, so all the queries are done in Python here. So I can't, and there's another way to like say if this is a meeting, then display this template. If it's a person, display that template without having a preconceived notion of the contact types. Cool. So let's go ahead and grab this list. We'll store it as an enum like that. Actually, no, not like that. Like this. Then we'll do a list. I forget what this is called. Not an interpolation list. Can't remember now. Anyway. Okay, so we find our model here. just define it wherever. Less comprehension, it just occurred to me. All right, so this is gonna be a class. Contact type choice, so singular, interesting. Yeah, so we're gonna deprecate this. Replace with an enum. This has another benefit, you know, not only of simplicity, but also making things explicit, and, you know, it's kind of documenting the worldview of the Western Friend organization and the Quaker community. So, you know, maybe has more value than where we have a flexible UI. And these don't change, really. So, I mean, we defined these in Drupal, like, a couple of years ago and haven't changed them, haven't really looked back. We need to change them all, you know, it's regular workflow, Git flow. And then person. So what we're trying to do also is have this generic notion of a contact that is anyone who's come into contact with the Western Friend organization or community. So that can be people or organizations, and there's sub. It's like a hierarchy, sort of these groupings of these Quaker meetings and worship groups. So I'm probably gonna have to end up kind of blasting my migrations. So it should be the same field, or at least my database here. Length to be short in this field, I believe, unless it's more memory efficient. Alright, so what I guess this is going to do is going to give us a tuple of key values. So it would be choice, choice value. Or the other way around, I guess. Maybe it's just a choice, choice value. Not sure how enums are. Sort of unpacked when you iterate over them. Okay, so that model's commented out. I think we can probably add now a search index. I don't know if we need this for faceted searching. You might need that. So I think they're using this haystack. We do want, imagine we'll want faceted searching. Okay, so with an enum, it's looking like we're going to lose faceting. This is mainly relevant in the search for the multimedia library, where we have a lot of facets over here, faceted search, when we do the counts and everything. So I'll hold off on putting the search engine on the index here. I'm not sure that we need it. Okay, can I import name contact type? Yeah, so we need to get rid of this. This is such a bummer to lose this. Anyway, I guess it's not too bad. Oh yeah, I see. That's interesting. Ah, there we go. There's the default. Well, that's fine. Oh, really nice. And then black formats those. Migrations, I should actually do that more often. Makes it a lot easier to read. Okay, good. Oh man, the migrations just worked. Section. What I need to do now. So the data is going to be really messed up, so. Should be tag.key, tag.value. This is a guess, but I think this should be key. This is pretty confusing. But since if we read this migration, okay, well, maybe I just won't do it with the enum. That's correct. That's how you. Although it should not be using the key, it should be using. Chat, anybody here familiar with Django or Python enums? And specifically using Python enums in a Django model. Otherwise, I just. We'll go with the way that this comes out of the docs. Man, I'm really rolling back to the basics here. Essentially, we need a tuple that looks like this. Okay, there we go. So, oh man. Why did black do this? This is. That's not correct. The tuple of tuples. Oh, because I didn't put commas. Alright, so no list comprehension. Simple and clean though. Alright, let's make these migrations. I don't think we need to migrate that. Or do we? Yes, we do. Cool. Welcome to the chat. Welcome to new viewers. We got Apricot, Droop Fruit, Commander Root, S1, and Ted. Well, those are some really difficult names and spellings. But anyway, welcome to the chat. Alright, so good. We have a nice error here. And it's from a previous migration. Damn it. Getting out of sync. I should delete and then add migration. So in other words, delete this table in its own migration. Yeah, it's clean and readable. And if I save it with black, it'll auto format. Should get a Git hook to do this auto-formatting too. It's nice. Keep my Django models migrations clean. Cool, because I don't really touch these files usually. So the database has gone out of sync. That's the problem, is migrations are fine. Trying to put my database back in a state it was before, where this model existed. Could just delete the thing, but I don't have sufficient dummy data generation. Seems like this should work, and if I just rerun a specific model, this one here. So maybe that's a safer bet. So switch out the field type. Then remove the model. Oops. Django squash migrations here. If I just get my database in a better state. Damn it. Whatever. Just gonna delete the database. I'll have to learn to avoid that in the future, just getting my database out of sync, running migrations, and then I don't know what happened if I don't even think I deleted it. Pretty complicated stuff, so yeah, I don't have to deal with that too much. Alright, cool, so we got a new num value. And I have to actually create admin. Cool, yeah. Wagtail comes with a multi-site out of the box, which is pretty cool. So a little bit of a snag. So gotta set that up initially. And I have some data dummy data generation scripts. I'll have to get more accustomed to those. Okay, cool. Looks like we got a few more people in the chat. Welcome, Noodles Butt. Orc Barney, Pinster. S1, Fakka is still here. Ted, Zane, Goober is here. And Kbra. If any of you have any experience with Python and Django, I'd be glad to have some pointers. I'm learning this all as I go. Particularly Wagtail has been really interesting to learn how it works. What all kind of projects are you all working on? I'd be curious to know as well. What technologies and what are you building? Now I'm just gonna stick in the contacts section for a little bit. I'm not gonna kind of mock out the whole site, but let's go ahead and select a yearly meeting contact type. So this is cool. These are working already. I guess because we're using an enum. Or no, we're using a tuple of tuples, and it's able to gather those apparently. Okay, very cool. So there's filter. Looking good. All right, so now if we do, go ahead and commit all these changes. It looks like I'm just going to continue now where I left off with the community directory. Okay, I'm trying to experiment also with this chat bot here. Supposed to be sending out periodic messages. If you'd like to interact with the IDE on the screen, you can send a chat command to highlight a line of code. You can see the command in the lower left-hand corner of the video. It's exclamation line, space the line number, and space an optional comment. It'll highlight the line as long as there's some code there. If there's no code, it can't highlight it. And it'll show your comment, so you can point out any kind of typos I'm making, or if you have any questions about the code. Oh, I just realized Toadshyler hadn't connected in the chat. There we go. Now we're set up. Cool. Yeah, just trying to make this code series a little bit more interactive. So all we've got here is community directory. And Another thing is these contacts should be hierarchical. So let me go ahead and fix that. What is job page? Child page types. Sub page types, there we are. Contacts aren't. I'm not sure if this is going to work, but let's try it out. Damn. They're not technically pages. I tried defining this as a page model too, and that was just a no-go because these fields are conditional and we don't want to use a title field. By default, pages have a title field. So what I was hoping to do is have the community directory, since there's a sort of a natural hierarchy of these meetings, worship groups can be part of monthly meetings can be part of yearly meetings, and there's another one called quarterly meeting. I need to add that to the list, so let me just go and do that. So I'm going to have to figure out how to do this hierarchical model. I think that's what this clusterable model is supposed to do, though. Or I could do a foreign key like parent contact. All right, I'll come to the hierarchy part later. I'll do a little bit more research on that, but I can flesh out this community page is what we're going to be working on now. So yearly meeting page was redundant, made now redundant. Let's run the server again, check it out, see if this foreign key works. Now what we need to do is at the top level, create the community page. Enter text, and here's the foreign key field we're working with right now. Let's just see if it pulls in from the, yes, it does, from the correct collection. View live. All right, we're gonna have a little bit of, because these contacts aren't pages, so I have to get the reverse URL. This removes one intermediary model, which was a page model and had all the kind of accoutrements of the page model, but now we're just using a regular Django model. So we just have to figure out in our template how to get the reverse URL. But anyway, this migration looks like it went fine. I actually should just delete the code outright, I think. And less is more. I enjoy having less code and being able to clean stuff up. This I'm going to leave in because essentially, we're going to be dealing with an events calendar type content, and part of the community page will be to list some upcoming events. So I was leaving this context in there. That works. Basically another field here for intro text. I'll move the intro here. How do you bring up the inline docs? I can't remember. Should be a way to do it. On JupyterLab, it's Shift Tab. Control Tab. Oh, there it went. So you can allow it to be empty. So basically, we want to have a little bit of text in the community page. If we look at the official website right now, the reference implementation, so to speak. Community page lists these yearly meetings under the directory, and we just have a little bit of text there we want to display on each one of these. I'll probably follow suit here. I have to figure out how to do these other ones. It's a little bit of hard coding now, but you know, it's the way of Django. You have to kind of hard code some of this stuff so that you can structure the templates correctly and get the query sets exactly as you'd expect. All right, so there we go. Tried a more dynamic way, and it was just kind of mind-bogglingly difficult. And every time, every path I sort of followed through in my mind and sort of did a little bit of research on it, it just didn't seem like it was going to work. There would be some kind of just really big difficulty we'd encounter there. So, okay, add intro field. And, back to that error page and see what's going on. Okay. Yeah, so I have to get that. Reference here. I think I can borrow this from the magazine because we're using the contact as the magazine article author. So let's try first. Just checking here. I don't think I'm to define a view, just. Sorry, actually, I just need to look at the templates. Yes, the templates was the correct place. Magazine templates, article summary is fine. Author by count. Okay. This. What we're looking for. Might need to define a string method. STR. We'll see what it looks like. But if I come back here to the community templates, community page. because these are contacts, they'll have slugs because I have a slug field in the contact. I believe this is fine. Reverse match. Let's try it first without this HRF to see if it's going to work. Yeah, so that's working. We got a link. We have it. Let's get some intertext back here, panels. Without losing my copy text, but anyway. If we edit this page. There we go. So yeah, that's all working. So need to just figure out what's going on with this reverse URL. But I think this is not going to be a difficult one. Just a matter of reading carefully what code I've already written. I'm reading that error, but no reverse match. Contact detail. Which arguments? Oh, I know the problem. So this yearly meeting is an instance of this join. So it doesn't have, as it's telling me, more or less it doesn't have this slug property. That's no problem. I just have to reach into the contact. That's why I have these meta, sort of these join models or these proxy models can introduce so much confusion and complexity. So less is more, but now we have this slug because the yearly meeting now has that property basically. I just introduced, so five it, and things work good. And now notice we're in contact land. So from the communicate page, we can have multiple yearly meetings. Each with a little introductory text. The next part will be to model the contact page. Our URLs are gonna change. That's just the way they're going there. But I have to now, that we have hard-coded contact types, I can display bespoke templates for these. I'll have to figure out the way to model the hierarchical relationships because these yearly meetings consist of quarterly meetings, which consist of monthly meetings, and we'll have to make those explicit so that I can query the monthly meetings belonging to IMYM. tricky one. Wagtail page model would have done that for free, but again, came back to this problem of the title field needs to be derived from these other fields, given name and family name. Because title, when you're referring to a person or a contact or an organization, it means something different than page. Another cool thing I might be able to figure out, it should be possible that this foreign key selector only shows yearly meetings. So set up a query set for that. Let me look that up real quick. Maybe that's something I can do. Sure how Wagtail is doing this. This might be a Wagtail specific question. Choosing a page, so we're not using this panel, but I thought it might be worth checking out. Not defining the model admin. Yeah, nothing readily available in the search. I'll leave that one alone for now. That's a pretty good session. We're back basically where we left off. The community page is working. Whoops. It's showing the contact. We're going to link to the contact. The next part of this directory of meetings needs to be the hierarchical model. So it's a little bit late here. It's about 2 a.m. I think I'm going to go ahead and call it good. I got these commits and they're pushed to GitHub. If you want to contribute to the code base, we'd welcome any new contributors. We do have some sort of smaller issues that are low-hanging fruit. And I could help you get set up with the development environment. It's pretty straightforward. We're not too complicated. We don't have too many moving parts in the build. So it's basically a virtual environment. It's about the most complicated part. of setting up the environment. All right, well, thanks for everybody who has checked out the live stream. Appreciate y'all hanging out in the chat. And to anybody on YouTube, feel free to leave a question or comment, and I'll respond in a timely manner. All right, thanks again for watching, and have a great day.